Okay, we're demoing the restaurant CMS. I'm Jay Belfour, software director at Widely Interactive, and I will go ahead and log into the backend admin panel. And we initially open up to the content tab where we see a few editable content areas that appear within the site. Clicking on the edit icon will open a simplified WYSIWYG text editor. But let's go ahead and go back to the menus tab, and we'll select a different restaurant that we want to manage. And so I'll select Bistro New York, which is a fictitious restaurant. And we're going to add a new breakfast menu, so I'll click the Add Menu button and enter in a title. Price and description are optional, so I'll leave those blank. I'll go ahead and save, and we see breakfast shows up last, so I'll reorder it since breakfast typically is the first meal of the day. Notice that the red button here says Show, which means it's not currently publicly visible on the website. I'll go ahead and click on breakfast and go one level deeper on the menu. Here's where the various sections of the menu will be entered, so let's go ahead and add a few. I'll add a section first, and again the price and description are optional. I'm going to add sides, and I want them all to be $3, so I'll input a price too. Next I'll add a section omelets, and I might want to have different prices for them, so I'll leave the price blank. Now I'll add a quick note to appear on the menu that egg white substitutions are available on request. And then I want to add an omelet, so I'll click another level deeper, and I'm going to add a Denver omelet. So I'll input a price of $13 and a short description. So now I can go back to the top level and preview what I've worked on so far. And I'll click on the view button so I can preview it. Okay, and let's say I'm ready to publish. So what I'll do is go back and click on the show button and it instantly becomes published on the website. But now I'm gonna delete it since we don't want this to appear on the demo site. Okay, so next I'm gonna run through adding a news post and maybe it's for Delicious Burger instead of Bistro New York. So I'll quickly switch restaurants. Then I'll click the Add News Item button. We'll give it a title. Maybe the restaurant now offers a kids menu. And here you'll see some inputs for time and date to publish to the website. This feature basically allows you to add news posts that won't appear on the site until a future time. Maybe it corresponds to a press release. At any rate, we'll leave it as is, which is the current local time for the restaurant. And then we're going to add a description, and I'll copy and paste some filler text here. I'll then add an image that I have ready to go. And once that's done uploading, we now have the ability to select a region to crop. And this is set up to be a fixed ratio, which enforces consistency across the site with the images. Also, there's an option here for PDF attachments that you can upload, which we'll skip for this post. And I'll go ahead and save it. Okay, so now we can preview the post by clicking the View button, and then we can see it appears also on the home page. And that's it for this demo. Thank you for watching. Please contact us if you'd like to discuss this solution.